गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू यू इन टुडेज लेक्चर। डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी हैड सीन फर्स्ट टू मेथड्स मेजरिंग इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड। जनरली रेशियो मेथड एज वेल एज टोटल आउटले मेथड विच इज नोन एज टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर मेथड, दीज टू मेथड्स मेजरिंग प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड we had seen in last lecture. Dear friends, in today's lecture we are going to learn about last method which is used to measure price elasticity of demand, known as point method. It is also called as geometric method. So it is the method which used to measure price elasticity of demand. Dear friends, it is very easy method to measure price elasticity of demand on a particular point on the demand curve. Dear friends, ratio method and total outlay method, these two methods we have already learned in last lecture. So that ratio method and total outlay method are unable to measure elasticity of demand at given point on a demand curve. So रेशियो मेथड एज वेल एज टोटल आउटले मेथड, बोथ मेथड्स आर अनेबल टू मेजर इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड एट ए गिवन पॉइंट ऑन द डिमांड कर्व, एंड देयरफॉर प्रोफेसर अल्फ्रेड मार्शल डेवलप पॉइंट मेथड। हु हैज डेवलप पॉइंट मेथड? प्रोफेसर अल्फ्रेड मार्शल डेवलप पॉइंट मेथड, एंड इट इज possible to measure with the help of point method elasticity of demand at a given point on the demand curve. Dear friends, first two methods which we have already learned, ratio method as well as total outlay method, these two methods are unable to measure elasticity of demand at a given point on the demand curve, and therefore Professor Alfred Marshall developed one more method to measure price elasticity, which is called as point or geometric method. So it is possible to measure with the help of point method. It is also developed by Alfred Marshall, and this method is useful to measure elasticity of demand at a particular point on the demand curve. So with the help of point method, how we will measure price elasticity? So it is the formula, point elasticity of demand at a particular point, so is equal to lower segment of demand curve below a given point divided by upper segment of a demand curve above a given point. यानी कि पॉइंट मेथड का यूज करते हुए यदि हमें इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड मेजर करना है तो इस फार्मूला का यूज करना है. सो विच इज द फार्मूला? लोअर सिगमेंट ऑफ द डिमांड कर्व बिलो अ गिवन पॉइंट डिवाइडेड बाय अपर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व अबव अ गिवन पॉइंट. यानी कि जिस पॉइंट पर हमें इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड मेजर करना है वह पॉइंट के नीचे वाला पोर्शन डिवाइडेड बाय उस पॉइंट के ऊपर वाला पोर्शन, जिसे हम अपर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व कहते हैं. सो इट इज द फार्मूला विच यूज टू मेजर इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड विद द हेल्प ऑफ पॉइंट मेथड. डियर फ्रेंड्स, so suppose our demand curve is linear demand curve. So when our demand curve is linear in nature, so AB is our demand curve and it is linear, and when our demand curve is linear, then how to calculate elasticity of demand at a particular point on a linear demand curve? Dear friends, we know that price of the commodity is measured on y axis and quantity demanded is measured on x, and AB is our linear demand curve. So how we will calculate elasticity of demand at a particular point on linear demand curve? So we know that there is a particular formula to measure price elasticity, and that is elasticity of demand is equal to lower segment of demand curve below a given point divided by upper segment of demand curve above a given point. Suppose we want to measure प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड एट ए पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट ऑन डिमांड कर्व. सो सपोज वी वांट टू मेजर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑन पी पॉइंट. विच पॉइंट? पी पॉइंट. सो व्हाट विल बी द फॉर्मूला? लोअर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व बिलो अ गिवन पॉइंट. सपोज पी इज गिवन पॉइंट. सो लोअर सेगमेंट ऑन डिमांड कर्व. सो पी बी इट विल बी लोअर सेगमेंट डिवाइडेड बाय अपर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व अबव अ गिवन पॉइंट. सो विच विल बी अपर सेगमेंट? सो पी ए. पी ए विल बी अपर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व. सो पी बी डिवाइडेड बाय पी ए. देन वी विल कैलकुलेट विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस फार्मूला प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. सो सपोज ऑन पी पॉइंट. सो वी वॉन्ट टू मेजर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑन पी पॉइंट. अब यदि हमें पी पॉइंट पर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी मेजर करना है, सो प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड एट पी पॉइंट इज इक्वल टू लोअर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व पी बी डिवाइडेड बाय अपर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व पी ए. सपोज ए बी इट इज 8 सेंटीमीटर. व्हाट विल बी द डिस्टेंस? ए बी 8 सेंटीमीटर. एंड सपोज पी इज एट मिडल पॉइंट, सेंट्रल पॉइंट है, एंड वी वांट टू मेजर हियर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी. सो पी बी लोअर सेगमेंट डिवाइडेड बाय पी ए अपर सेगमेंट. सो 4 डिवाइडेड बाय 4, व्हाट विल बी आंसर? 1. सो हियर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड विल बी 1. इन अनदर वर्ड इट इज यूनिटरी इलास्टिक डिमांड. विच इज यूनिटरी इलास्टिक डिमांड एट पी पॉइंट ऑन अ डिमांड कर्व. तो इस प्रकार यदि हमें पी पॉइंट पर इलास्टिसिटी मेजर करना है, तो पी पॉइंट से नीचे वाला पोर्शन जिसे हम लोअर सेगमेंट कहेंगे पी बी डिवाइडेड बाय अपर सेगमेंट पी ए. इस प्रकार 4 डिवाइडेड बाय 4 इज इक्वल टू 1. तो हियर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी विल बी यूनिटरी इलास्टिक डिमांड. देन सपोज वी वांट टू मेजर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी एट पी वन पॉइंट. यदि हमें पी वन पॉइंट पर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी मेजर करना है, तो वी नो फार्मूला लोअर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व बिलो अ गिवन पॉइंट. सो विच विल बी लोअर सेगमेंट? पी वन बी. पी वन बी डिवाइडेड बाय अपर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व अबव अ गिवन लोअर सेगमेंट डिवाइडेड बाय अपर सेगमेंट. सो विच विल बी अपर सेगमेंट? पी पी वन ए. विच विल बी पी वन ए. सो पी वन बी डिवाइडेड बाय पी वन ए. सपोज पी वन बी इज 2 सेंटीमीटर. सो रिमेनिंग विल बी 6 सेंटीमीटर बिकॉज होल डिमांड कर्व ए बी हैविंग 8 सेंटीमीटर डिस्टेंस. सो पी बी डिवाइडेड बाय पी वन बी. पी वन बी डिवाइडेड बाय पी वन ए. सो 2 डिवाइडेड बाय 6 इज इक्वल टू 0.33. इन अनदर वर्ड इट इज रिलेटिवली इन इलास्टिक डिमांड. इट मीन्स इट इज लेस देन 1. सो हियर इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड एट पी वन पॉइंट विल बी लेस देन 1 बिकॉज आवर आंसर इज 0.33 विच इज लेस देन 1. सो रिलेटिवली इनइलास्टिक डिमांड विल बी हेयर एट पी वन पॉइंट. देन सपोज वी वॉन्ट टू मेजर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी एट पी टू पॉइंट ऑन अ डिमांड कर्व. सो हेयर वी नो दैट फार्मूला लोअर सेगमेंट ऑफ डिमांड कर्व बिलो अ गिवन पॉइंट. सो लोअर सेगमेंट सो पी टू बी डिवाइडेड बाय अपर सेगमेंट पी टू ए. सपोज पी टू बी इज 6 सेंटीमीटर. सो रिमेनिंग डिस्टेंस पी टू A will be 2. So 6 divided by 2, answer will be 3. And now here, elasticity of demand, particularly price elasticity of demand, will be greater than 1 because answer is 3, which is more than 1. So here, relatively elastic demand will be there at P2 point. So at P2 point, there will be relatively elastic demand. In another word, it is greater than 1. Then, if we want to measure price elasticity of demand at A point. यदि हमें A point पर price elasticity measure करना है, तो we know the formula lower segment of demand curve below a given point divided by upper segment of demand curve above a given point. So here we want to measure price elasticity at a point. Dear friends, here a point is touched to the y-axis, and here we want to measure price elasticity. So lower segment, it means AB. What will be lower segment? AB, and A is the last point of our demand curve which touch to y-axis, and therefore upper segment of demand curve above a given point. So A ke baad point hi nahi hai, so A will be last point. So A se A tak, AA, upper segment will be AA, it means 0. So AB, lower segment 8, AA 0, so 8 divided by 0, answer will be infinite. So in this case, price elasticity will be infinite when demand curve, the point on demand curve, when touched to the y-axis, there will be infinite elastic demand. And lastly, if we want to measure price elasticity of demand at a particular point on a demand curve where demand curve touch to the x-axis, suppose here B point, where we want to measure price elasticity, so formula should be apply here. So lower segment, iske niche wala segment hai, portion nahi hai, because B is the last point of our demand curve. So BB, lower segment, iske niche kuch bhi nahi hai, so BB, because B is the last point of our demand curve, so which touch to the x-axis here, and so it will be 0, BB 0, upper segment of demand curve above a given point. Ab iske upar wala portion, so AB will be that portion, so 0 divided by 8, answer will be 0. So here we can conclude that when a point on demand curve touch to the x-axis, then there will be 0 elastic demand. There will be 0 elastic demand. So in this way we may measure price elasticity of demand at different prices, at different points on a demand curve. So B, P1, P, P2 and A, these are different points where we have measure price elasticity of demand. When that point is at central point of the demand curve, elasticity will be 1. If it is on x-axis, there will be 0 elastic demand. If it is touched to the y-axis, there will be infinite demand. So when we move up on the demand curve, elasticity of demand goes to rises. Here 0 less than 1, 1 more than 1, and lastly infinite. In another word, when we move down on the demand curve, elasticity of demand is goes to decreases. Dekhiye, y per infinite hai, p2 per more than 1, p per 1 less than 1, and 0. So in this way we may measure elasticity of demand when demand curve is linear in nature with the help of point method. If our demand curve is non-linear demand curve, if our demand curve is non-linear, then how to measure price elasticity of demand with respect to non-linear demand curve? So here DD is our non-linear demand curve, and if we want to measure price elasticity of demand at E point on the DD demand curve, यदि हमें E point पर जो कि non-linear demand curve DD पर है, यहाँ पर यदि हमें प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी मेजर करना है, तो किस प्रकार से मेजर करना है? सो हियर व्हेन डिमांड कर्व इज नॉन लीनियर, व्हेन डिमांड कर्व इज नॉन लीनियर, इन अनदर वर्ड व्हेन इट इज कॉन्वेक्स टू द ओरिजिन, सो टू मेजर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड वी हैव टू ड्रॉ अ टेंजेंट ए बी टचिंग द गिवन पॉइंट ऑन द डिमांड कर्व and extending it to meet y-axis at A point and x-axis at B point. Whenever we want to measure price elasticity of demand at a particular point on the demand curve, suppose DD is our demand curve, which is non-linear demand curve. DD is non-linear demand curve, and we want to measure price elasticity at E point, so we have to draw a tangent which touch to that particular point, as well as which must be extending to x as well as y axis. So here it is the tangent AB which touch to that particular point and which meet to y axis at A point and x axis at B point, and there will be a particular formula to measure price elasticity, which is the formula lower segment of tangent below a given point divided by upper segment of the tangent above a given point. It means so here, if we want to measure price elasticity at E point, so formula will be lower segment of the tangent below a given point divided by upper segment of the tangent above a given point. So which will be lower segment of the tangent? EB. EB will be lower segment divided by upper segment of the tangent above a given point. So which will be upper segment? EA. So here EB divided by EA, then we may calculate price elasticity of demand at E point on non-linear demand curve. So here there are three type of possibilities. First one, if EB is equal to EA, if EB is equal to EA, then there will be unitary elastic demand, because when EB is equal to EA, suppose EB is 4 centimeter and EA also 4 centimeter, so 4 divided by 4, answer will be 1. So there will be unitary elastic demand when that point is at the central point on the tangent. In another word, when EB is equal to EA, then there will be unitary elastic demand. Then if EB is greater than EA, if EB is greater than EA, then there will be relatively elastic demand. Suppose that point where we want to measure price elasticity, suppose it is in that here, suppose E point is here on the tangent, then lower segment of the tangent will be more than upper segment. As a result, answer of the formula lower segment divided by upper segment will be more than 1, and therefore there will be relatively elastic demand. And last possibility, that is when EB is less than EA, when EB is less than EA, in another word, when lower segment is less than upper segment, then there will be relatively inelastic demand. Which type of demand? Relatively inelastic demand, because answer of the formula will be less than 1 in this case. So in this way, we may measure price elasticity of demand with the help of point method. So demand curve may be linear or it may be non-linear. There are two formulas which we have to learn, and when we apply that formula, then we may calculate, we may measure price elasticity of demand at any point on the demand curve. That demand curve may be linear or non-linear.